Now, I'm going to be doing a comparison with the Google Pixel 8 versus the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 5. And you might be thinking, this is an unfair comparison, but honestly, guys, these are two of the newest phones from both phone manufacturers. And, you know, the Pixel 8 is a really good phone in its own right. It's selling for about 700 bucks right now. Google upped the price on their Pixel phones this year by about 100 bucks. And the design on these phones is really good. You know, it's gotten better each iteration, in my opinion. You know, if we look back at the Pixel 4 and 5, you know, it was like plastic, and then they changed the design with the Pixel 6. It went all glass, and, you know, you've got some different color options with this phone, and it's a really nice phone. I've said these Pixel phones are great alternatives to getting a, you know, iPhone or even a Samsung phone, because that's just the truth. Plus, they typically hold their value for at least like 2 to 3 years. So the value on these Pixel phones actually holds up if you want to do a trade-in at some point. Now, if you want to be a complete boss, then, you know, the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold series, especially the Z Fold 5, is just where it's at. You know, you're not going to find a cooler phone in the market right now, but comes with a steep price, right? You're paying, you know, always over $1,000. You know, this is going to be right now right around like $1,700, depending on the gig size you get. So not everybody is going to want to buy a Z Fold series phone, but I will say this about it. You know, it's awesome for multitasking, especially when it's open. You can really do two things at once on this phone, unlike any other phone out there. And as far as watching video on it, you know, you might never need to use your TV again, because, you know, when this thing is opened up and you're, you know, watching whatever streaming service, whether it's Netflix, Hulu, something else, you can really just like get that full entertainment experience on this phone like nothing else out there. Then, of course, it's great for gaming. It's great for, you know, video recording, taking pictures. And really the only thing I would say the Pixel 8 has on the Z Fold 5 is probably going to be the battery life. You know, the Pixel phones have really good battery lives. And one thing about using a bigger phone like the Z Fold is that it tends to just like take that juice, you know, a lot quicker. It's not terrible, you know what I'm saying, but you are going to be charging this phone a little bit more. But here's what I'm saying, guys. If you are thinking about getting a new phone or upgrading to something, just grab the Z Fold 5, man. You know, even if you go back, whatever, one generation with the Z Fold 4, it's still a really good phone too. I mean, not too much different on the Z Fold 5 from the 4, but I'll tell you what, these phones are just, they're awesome, and you're not going to regret it. Plus, you know, they're going to be good for 2 to 3 years down the road, and they also hold their trade-in value as well. So if you wanted to trade it in after a year or two, you know, upgrade to something else, you know, it's going to hold its trade-in value, which is super important when you're, you know, buying a phone overall. Okay, anyways, next thing I'm going to do here is run some video, and then we're going to do some more gaming on the Z Fold 5, because it is going to be my top choice out of these two phones. Of course, if you want to learn more about either one of them, or get on our tech newsletter, we'll have some great resource links directly below in the description. For now, Liz, run it.
Chill, chill! I'm afraid your path ends here. Supreme!